What's up, you guys? Martin here, and welcome back to my channel. So today, we are out and about. Today, we're running errands. We're going to Petco. We are looking for some saltwater fishies. We have a nice project that we have not really been showing, but we got something out there. And we're just going to go out. Okay, we're going to go to Tarjay. I'm craving Jamba Juice. I might get a Jamba Juice. I always say I'm going to get Jamba Juice when we go to that town, and I never do, but I'm craving one, okay? And it's just going to be a day of vlogging. I have a taste test to do with you guys, and let's just get out, because I'm going cray-cray. We are at Tarjay. This is where we go. Tarjay. El Target. Yeah. Mission accomplished. Yeah. All right, so just got done going to Wingstop. We got a whole box of food. And now Petco, where the pets go, to see if there's any fun saltwater creatures or anemones or corals. We don't know yet. We're going. All right. We are coming to our favorite place, El Petco. This Petco is honestly one of the better ones. We've been to some really ratchet ones, and they take care of their animals here, so yeah. There it is. All right, here we go. All right, you guys, so we successfully got a sixth line race, or RAS. I can never say it right. The colors look awesome. Blues, greens, pinks. Love him. All right, we just got home, and our big coral tree display, our live rock, came in. Perfect timing. It was supposed to be here yesterday, but UPS rescheduled, but it's a big box. So we're getting everything together. Big box. Big tank.
The next day.
All right, it is the next day. I wanted to show you guys the tank, but it was really cloudy. Today, everything settled. We put Pinhead, our, what is it, striped box or? A spiny box puffer. He was in the 13 gallon. It was just a temporary thing, but he is looking hecka happy here. I'm not even kidding. Look how cute he looks. Yeah, so Pinhead was just temporarily in the smaller tank just because, you know, we were having this big idea, and it's just crazy. It's really plain right now. We're gonna add so much more to this. So excited, but he is doing great, little boy. There's Pinhead. Hi baby, water baby. You miss daddy, huh? So that is Pinhead. He is loving his new enclosure. We have a six-line RAS hiding in the coral, but it's looking good. So we are headed to Aquarium Reptile Depot in Citrus Heights, California. We're gonna go check out some awesome fish. I'm excited. All right, guys, we are in Citrus Heights, California, and we are here at the Aquarium Reptile Depot. But we're here hella early. They open at 11, it's like 10:50 something. So we're kind of like those people that are like annoying, where we're just standing or sitting in the parking lot. Even when they open, we'll wait a couple more minutes. Because I don't want to be like right there, you know? But yeah. Ew, Leo wants to go right when they open. Oh my God, I told you guys I did not want to go in right when it's happening. We're really going?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, so we're really going in here. I don't want to be one of those people where it's like, you wait till it's open. Oh no. Oh my God, here we go. This is so cool. All the fish your heart can desire. Look at all these. Look at how beautiful. Oh my God. The babies. Wow. This purple one's really, really nice.
1 hour later.
All right, so we have our snowflake eel. We have a trigger fish. Look how cool. Love, 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 love. And then we have our blue spotted puffer. All right, so right now I decided I'm gonna try to make flan for the first time. So Leo tends to make flan a lot, especially when we go to friends' houses, when we go to parties, events, stuff like that. But I wanna try to make flan because it's so good and sometimes I crave it and I can't make it. So we're gonna try to make this together. I just found a recipe and we're just gonna go with it. And we're gonna see how this looks. So this is a new thing for me, as it is for you. And we still have to try something. We will try that, we'll taste test that in a bit. But right now, we're making flan. And right now, that tank is looking fantastic. So this is the new addition to the animal family. We got an awesome saltwater tank. There's still a lot to do. We got some clownfish in here. We have Pinhead. Wendy chose him. I love him so much. We transferred him from the small tank to this tank. We have an eel, a snowflake eel. He's freaking awesome. We have a sixth. Ooh, Pinhead in the way. We have this six-lined wrasse. Really awesome, pretty colors. Pinhead is the star of the show. Pinhead, you little dork. We also have a blue spotted puffer. This thing is beautiful. The colors are so vibrant. And he keeps following me. And we have a triggerfish right there. Yes. So it's looking really, really good. It's like an ocean in your living room, and it's freaking awesome. So that's what we're dealing with right now. We are going to redo the smaller tank. We have a few of the fish in here still. We have our Mrs. Puff, our Valentini Puffer. We have a cardinal pajama, a pajama cardinal fish. We have a jawfish, a crab, an emerald crab, a shrimp. But we're going to redo this reef tank. So there's the pajama fish right there. There's the jawfish right there. I love him so much. He's so cute. He has a mind of his own. He spits out sand. Hey, dude. I got that freaking moss in the way. Oh, we have a gobby as well. And then Mrs. Puff right there. Nice. Look at you, beautiful. There she is. Enough with the fish. Let's make some flan. Believe it or not, we have all the ingredients. It's very random, since I guess Leo likes to cook this all the time, or bake it, however you want to say. We have everything for it, and I'm pretty stoked about it. So this is all you need, literally all you need. You need 5 large eggs. You need some vanilla, pure vanilla extract. 1 can of La Lechera sweetened condensed milk. It asks for 14 ounces of evaporated milk. I only have 10 ounces total, so I'm hoping this works.
Like I said, I'm just kind of winging this. So we're going to have evaporated milk. And it calls for half a cup of sugar, but I'm doing a whole damn sugar. I'm doing a whole damn cup. And this is where I keep my sugar. How cute is that? I mean, it's Halloween every day at my house, but still, look how cute. Oh, my baby ghosty. So, this is all you need.
And we're about to go bake up some flan.
Alright, so the first step, what we need to do is melt the sugar to make our caramel sauce. So, it says to do a medium-low heat, or low-medium heat. I have it at a 4 right now. I might even go to like 3. I'm just kind of scared. So basically, we're going to melt the sugar for 5 minutes to make a nice caramely sauce. And then the sauce will be put on the bottom of the dish you're going to use. Okay? So, like I said, it called for half a cup of sugar. But I'm going to go full cup because I like extra caramel sauce. So I don't think that would mess anything up. Here we go. And honestly, I'm scared. I've never melted sugar before, so this should be interesting. You want to keep at it, and you want to keep making sure you're evened. That way it's melting good, no chunks. And just be sure not to burn this or keep it in too long after it's melted because it can become bitter. So I will be back when this looks more like syrup, like caramel, caramel. Be right back. Alright, it is literally looking like caramel. Isn't that crazy? So we're going to continue this a little bit more to make sure all the lumps are out. And then we're going to pour it into our pot, our pan that we're going to use for... Oh my god, this is so cool. Look at how cool this looks. This must be really hot. Because it's bubbling. Ooh, that's bubbling, all right. All right, so this sugar is melted. I'm scared, it looks really hot. We're gonna pour it into our flan pan. All right, here we go. That looks so good, oh my gosh. This is liquid. Really excited for this. I did that right. All right, next up. All right, so now that we got that taken care of, the next step is to add our flan ingredients. So all we are going to be doing is adding 5 of those eggs, whole eggs, 5 of them, just like that. We're adding the entire can of the condensed sweetened milk. And the reason for that is this is what's giving our sweetness, right? This is what's doing it. All right, so we're gonna get this all in. Have you guys ever had this? I could literally get a spoon of this and just eat it. I'll probably get diabetes, but. Oh my gosh, this stuff is so good. This is fun. I like trying new recipes with you guys. At least stuff I've never done. Let me lick this. Oh my god. Oh my god. All right, the condensed milk is in. Next up, we're adding the 3 cans of the evaporated milk. These are 5 ounces each, but I'm gonna use 3. It calls for 14 ounces, but we're doing that extra. All right. Sorry, it's a little dark for you guys. This camera again, I need to get a new camera eventually. All right. Next up, you're adding 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Only 1 teaspoon. Don't think and don't try to say, oh, I'm gonna add a little bit more. Because if you add more than the 1 teaspoon, it's gonna make it bitter. We don't want bitter flan, all right? So 1 teaspoon. That is 1 teaspoon. All right, we are now gonna blend this for 2 minutes. 2 minutos. Alright, so we're adding the mixture into the flan pan. Oh my gosh. Just like this. It says to add the entire mixture, so that's what we're gonna do. Hopefully it won't overflow. Oh my god, that's so perfect.
Look at me being a baker. Oh my gosh. You guys. Perfect.
Alright, so now after we put the flan pan into a bigger pan, we are going to add the foil. Okay, we're going to add the foil to make it nice and twite. Twite like a twiga. My big ass hand's in the way. You're going to make that very tight. Now, after you're done with these, you are going to add water. We're doing a water bath to the flan. Also, have your oven preheated, okay? You should already know this. For any of you bakers out there, just do it. Don't ask questions. So, just put it at 350. We are going to add water. So, I just grabbed water from the blender. And you're not going to go all the way up. You're just going to do maybe like half. As long as it's not going to boil over, right? It's just a water bath. I think that's pretty darn good, to be honest. So we'll be like that. That'll be perfect. We're going to add four holes. So one, two, three, four in each corner. And then we're going to put this in, and we're going to bake this at 350 for 1 hora, hour. Here we go.
All right. Just like so, there it is. 1 hour.
All right, you guys, I told you I was going to do a taste test of something that's kind of out of this world. I didn't even know existed, but we're going to try it. I highly doubt this is gonna be good. I think it's gonna be really bad. Like, really bad. It is ice cream. I don't know if you guys heard this, but it's at Walmart and they have different flavors. They have like dessert flavors. They even have a pizza flavored ice cream. I tried to get that. They didn't have it, so I had to just do with what I had. And we're gonna be trying Kraft macaroni and cheese ice cream. Not good. So we're gonna open it. Wow, that's really freaking orange. Oh my god. Ew. Look how orange that is. I do the weirdest things for you guys, okay? So here we go. Kraft macaroni and cheese ice cream. This. All right, sorry about that. The camera died. Thank goodness it died right when I got the scoop. Oh my god. You could tell it's still that little same piece. It looks disgusting, and I'm hoping it's really good. I'm thirsty. It's hot in here. I'm quenching for something cold. All right, before I was rudely interrupted by my battery. Kraft macaroni and cheese French ice cream. This is its taste. Oh god. No. It literally tastes like if you mashed up a pot of macaroni and cheese, the saltiness from the cheese. Oh, hell no. Hell to the mother... No. This is like if you were to mash up a whole bunch of macaroni and cheese. What's that song go? The macaroni in the pot. That's a wet. But, it's if you mashed it and pureed that shit and then poured it into this and then put it in the freezer and then take it out and then go like this and then go like this. Hell no. Hell to the mother... No.
The next day.
Alright, you guys. So my flan came out like crap. Look at how ugly that is. It's kind of like not good. It's a fail. It's not cooked all the way, I don't think. I don't know. But I'm going to try to see how it tastes. I failed.
Look at that. That's the ugliest one I've ever seen in my life.
All right, so sorry it's loud. It's because I'm washing clothes right now. But we're going to try my messed up flan. Man, I thought I could make a flan. Maybe it was that extra carnation or evaporated milk. Well, here goes nothing. This messed up flan, this is its taste. It's so good though. Well, it tastes good, but I think it's messed up. It is what it is. All right, guys, that's gonna be it for today. If you guys like this video, please like, subscribe, favorite, share with your friends and family for more content. And until next time, you guys, don't be a lemon, be a rosebud. Peace.